Good evening, lovelies. Let me get us over to There we are. Good morning. Let me turn that other music off. Hello. Just the music, just a little bit. It's time. It's been a while. Thank you for the resub, Mattis. You know I love it. Welcome in. Yes, it's sleepy time. It's sleepy hours. We're here to do our thing. We're here to do Milkman. Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the Iris. I hope you're all having a good night tonight. Thank you for the follow. I hope we're all doing good tonight. I'm actually going to lower the volume of the stuff. I want to make tonight nice and cozy for you guys. It's been a while since we've had just like a real cozy night. So hold on one second. I'm just going to lower our audio down so that way when sound alerts come through they won't be as loud and we can kind of stay in the zone, the chill vibe zone, the sleepy zone, whatever we want to call it tonight. It's been a while, but I am excited to be back at it. We've got a ton of goodies. You're tired? Well, that's why you should be here today, Reeps. We're ready to go. We're gonna do all kinds of stuff tonight. Well, let me move myself over just a little bit. So tonight we're doing the International Wiki. I've got a good bunch of goodies lined up. I've got my sippy in hand, and it's been a while since we've had the chance to do this, but I'm good. You keep me awake on the night drive home. Bro, I don't think I can do that. Tonight's chill night. We're gonna be doing the chill. We're gonna be doing the relaxation. I'll try my best. You get to listen to me, though. My sweet dulcet tones. For once, I'm not yelling at you. Alright. We're gonna get started. This one is from the Japanese SCP Wiki. So this one's gonna be a little bit special, a little bit different. Let me get situated and adjust because apparently shoes is gonna be a big problem tonight. All right, let's go. SCP-1249-JP. SCP-1249-JP is classed as a Nagi. This must be, as far as I'm aware, I think that some designations exist outside of the regular SCP Wiki. There is a little footnote here, so we'll read it real quick. Anomalous designation. This class object Nagi has lost its anomalous hazardous properties for a long time due to whatever reason. The containment procedure is to be maintained, and if the anomaly shows signs or activities again, it would be immediately reassigned the appropriate object class. So it's basically been neutralized. So let's get rolling. Big stretch. Special Containment Procedures. The notebook in which SCP-1249-JP is written is held in a low-security containment locker at SCP Site 8154 and is not to be removed except for express research purposes. Description. Oh, I skipped ahead. It's been so long since I've done this that I've lost my proverbial touch. I apologize. New instances of SCP-1249-JP are discovered. Two or more agents are to be sent to recover it immediately. The box. Radical Cole. That is just the. Okay, Hiragana for Cole. Is to be drawn around the instance of SCP-1249-JP, and the object on which the instance is written is to be retrieved for containment. Disappearances of people caused by SCP-1249-JP's effects are to be handled with an appropriate cover story. Description. SCP-1249-JP is a drawing composed from the kanji for person, repeated several times, and is currently thought to be read as Nakashinden Takeo to Shirakawa Minami to Itoa Harutaka to Shio. Fucking words. Shio Iwa Ryuji, Ose Rin to Hikita Shose to Hagiwara Itsuka. This includes the names of people affected by SCP-1249-JP. The Japanese part of Koto literally means and. SCP-1249-JP appears to be written in black ink, but its composition has not been discovered. It is thought that prior to containment, SCP-1249-JP carried a memetic anomaly that made the aforementioned reading apparent to subjects who viewed the drawing in person. Prior to containment, people near the notebook in which SCP-1249-JP is written would have their names added to the reading of SCP-1249-JP over the course of 20 seconds, and it is thought that the case of multiple people being in range would be picked up at random. After affected subjects would disappear, a person or a character would be added to the drawing. The affected subject's whereabouts are currently unknown. The above anomalous effects are purely conjecture based on the information in Addendum 1249-JP.2 and are confirmed. SCP-1249-JP's true anomalous properties are currently under research. Addendum 1249-JP-1 Discovery. SCP-1249-JP was discovered in 2018 on May 19th in the home of Takeo Nakashinden, located in Itokawa Ward, Tokyo. At first, the Foundation was informed of people disappearing after entering the home of Mr. Nakashinden, whose whereabouts were unknown, and sent one agent to investigate. Upon discovery, SCP-1249-JP's reading was confirmed as Nakashinden Takeo to Shirakawa Minami to. I'm not gonna read all of this again because I'm just going to struggle, and I know I will. I'm so sorry. From this reading, it is thought that Mr. Nakashinden, his partner Minami Shirakawa, and two of the police officers, Harutaka Itoa and Ryuji Shioiwa, who entered the home for initial investigation, were the four people who had been affected by SCP-1249-JP's anomalous effects. The search for the aforementioned people is still ongoing. Hi, Goob! Welcome in! It's SCP Nightblood! And I turned off Poppet tonight. We're going for vibes. We're going for vibes. How are you doing? Mr. Nakashinden has been conducting studies related to the kanji at Blank University, and it is known that he had a hobby of constructing quote-unquote original kanji, which is thought to relate to the creation of SCP-1249-JP. It has also been confirmed that the notebook on which SCP-1249-JP is written is completely non-anomalous. Aww, thank you. Very glowy. I'm glad that you're doing well tonight. Several pages of this notebook contain drawings thought to be non-existent kanji in their readings, written in pencil or pen. And thus, it is thought that the notebook was used by Mr. Nakashinden for his hobby in constructing original kanji. These drawings appear to be non-anomalous. Addendum 1249-JP-2. Details regarding neutralized classification. Earlier, when we were reading this, it did state that the classification had been changed to Nagi to indicate that the SCP itself had been neutralized. The following is a transcript of a video recording of SCP-1249-JP's discovery. Agent Sawada, embedded with the police force at the time, as well as three police officers, Rin Ose, Shose Hikitaka, and Itsuka Hagia, Hirada. Front matter omitted. Ose, everyone come here. All three of the officers, Agent Sawada, gather in the living room. Sawada, what is it? Ose, this note. It looks like it has kanji written on it, but... Hikitaka, Nakashinden Takeo to Shirakawa Minai to Itoa. You can read it. These names... What happened to Ose? Rin Ose is confirmed to have disappeared. Hikitaka. I keep saying Hikitaka. It's Hikata. No, Hikita. Hikita. Wait a second. This one read Ose Rin. Hagiwara. Wait, this is weird. Sawara to command softly. We found the SCP. I think I'll bring it in for containment. Hikita. What the hell's going on? Hagiwara. I don't know, but people are disappearing. Let's get the hell out of here. Hikita. Fuck, calm down. Let's just... Shose Hikita disappears. The disappearance is caught on camera and is instantaneous. Sawara. Hikita. Hagiwara sitting on the ground. Sawara, please help. What is this? What's happening? Sawara. Hagiwara, get up, quick, get out of here right now. Agent Sawara picks up SCP-1249-JP's notebook and exits. Mr. Nakashinden's home, along with Itsuka Hagiwara, upon exiting the front door, has discovered that Officer Hagiwara has disappeared. Sawara, Hagiwara? Ah, fuck, what do I do? Sawara shouts loudly and then begins to talk to himself as if panicked. Sawara, wait. If this is a kanji, then... Sawara quickly retrieves a marker from his breast pocket and draws a box radical around SCP-1249-JP. Agent Sawada, how's that, ya fucker? What a way to contain an SCP. Draw a box around it. Following this, Agent Sawada successfully returned to site 8154 with SCP-1249-JP without suffering its anomalous effects. It is thought that the box radical around SCP-1249-JP serves as an ideograph form of containment for SCP-1249-JP. It was also determined that SCP-1249-JP's anomalous properties were related to its composition as a kanji. When SCP-1249-JP was brought Site 8154, it had lost all anomalous properties, and although attempts were made to restore its anomalous properties in order to conduct experiments, none were successful. Thus, SCP-1249-JP was classified as Nagi. Attempts to replicate the anomalous properties of SCP-1249-JP are still underway. Ideographically, it looks like it could. I'm worried. That was SCP-1249-JP from the Japanese SCP Wiki. I really like running across these random new SCPs. They always make me happy. Oh, this one's got a little spider friend. This one's from... This is Deutsch. Oh, this is the German SCP branch. What's Spider Friend doing in the German SCP branch? Let's see. SCP-184-DE. Object class, safe. Threat level, yellow. Oh, he's kind of cute. Little guy. Hold on, I wish I could show you guys. Might show you guys if I get the chance. I'll show you this little guy. He's so stinking cute. We'll show him in a second. He's very adorable, though. SCP-184-D is to be stored in a containment locker. Subjects equipped with SCP-184-DE must be watched by at least two persons at any moment during testing. Researchers inside of the testing area must remain cautious and should only move slowly. In case of emergencies, the effects may be reversed by holding the subject in place and carefully bending one of their legs until it breaks. In this case, at least one employee with medical training should be nearby to immediately treat the injury. Description: SCP-184-DE is a himbation, piece of cloth worn over the mantle. A piece of cloth worn as a mantle over a chitin, or a chitin in classical antiquity, made of spider silk. If SCP-184-DE is worn by a person as their only piece of clothing around their torso, it instantly transforms itself and the wearer into an arachnid of the order Araenae. The body's center of mass is preserved throughout, resulting in the subject dropping about 1 meter in height. Precise species appears to be random, but stays constant for every person over multiple uses. Subjects retain their cognitive ability, but perception and instincts become those of a normal spider of the same species. Test subjects transformed this way are capable of understanding research personnel and communicating with them. Upon being injured in spider form, subjects transform back and will feature wounds analogous to those that were caused during the transformation. The circumstances of the transformation often lead to further damage to the subject. The only known method to transform a subject back to its honest expression is deep affection towards the subject. Now we have a chart here that lists off a bunch of different things about it. Oh, Astra! Hello, my baby! Welcome in! Oh, everybody, this is my baby, Astra. I'm her model mama. Welcome, we're talking about this cute little spider thing. Welcome in. So this chart gives us a description of all the different D-class that we have interacted with in the pursuit of understanding this SCP a little better. D08153, light skin, brown hair, green eyes, turned into Alopecia tribalis, which is a wolf spider. Interesting. How are you doing tonight, Astra? D08-27 turned into an autumn orb weaver. D09-202 turned into a caterpillar jumping spider. D09-11 into a fence post jumper. D07-43 turned into a lace web spider. D07-234 turned into a diadem spider. D24-10 turned into Thanatus formiculus. It should be noted that this particular D-class also suffered from albinism, which means that this particular species was picked by the SCP itself to mimic their natural pigmentation. O9656, Brazilian wandering spider. And 08312, a fairy lamp spider. Very interesting. Discovery. SCP-184-DE was discovered on January 8th, 2009, following an emergency call due to a spider bite caller, JM, aged at 26, the day of, was found dead in a forest cabin. The corpse of a woman, later identified as AW, aged 29, clothed in SCP-184-DE, was found lying nearby. The left half of her body completely smashed. The cause of death was determined to be liver failure caused by the venom of a Chilean recluse spider. The man and severe contusions resulting in internal hemorrhage for the woman. It is of note that the response to call was made yet the victim was already found in liver mortis. So this SCP is pretty interesting. It takes a neat little angle at the idea of transformation. I like the concept that it all remains by the looks that it seems like you remain most of your keep most of your humanity intact, even as a spitter. It's pretty neat. It's a really interesting concept. Let's see, let's get another one here. Oh, this is another one from the JP Wiki. Hi, Jack! Tonight we're doing this is gonna be big vibes. We're doing big chill vibes tonight. Big sippy. We're doing nice vibes, we're doing chill vibes. Settle in, we're gonna just relax. This one comes to us from the JP Hub. Big chill vibe. Most relaxing chill vibes you can get. SCP-2077-JP. Object class safe. Special Containment Procedures. SCP-2077-JP is contained in a medium-sized locker in Basement 3 of Site 644. Assigned personnel are to ensure that the insertion slot on the top of the object and the waste bin at the bottom of the object are empty. Wish it's night over here. Oh yeah, you do live in a different time zone. Well, there's always the VOD. I'll make sure we publish the VOD so that people can, listen to it whenever. I might even cut it down and we'll post it on YouTube. Although it has been confirmed that SCP-2077-JP's anomalous properties are not affected by lack of power supply, a 50Hz AC power supply may be provided to SCP-CN-2077 during testing to allow its blades to move. During testing, blades are found to be too dull to shred the object. There appears to be a risk of such, the site director is to be notified immediately. Although it has been previously reported that personnel have been harmed. Oh. Hippo! Welcome into the chat. Welcome to the Iris. I hope you're having a good night tonight. Thank you for stopping by and thank you for the follow. Although it has been previously reported that personnel have been harmed by the blades, this has been determined to not be part of the anomaly. To protect personnel, reinforced gloves intended to prevent cutting damage as well as military-grade ear protection are authorized. In addition, tests are to take place in soundproof chambers, if possible. SCP-2077-JP is a hand-operated document shredder manufactured in 19. Redacted. When shredding objects, SCP-2077-JP will produce a loud operating noise and produce a reinterpretation of the content of shredded materials of high quality on A4 size paper. Experiment 2020 redacted 23. So we don't know when this experiment happened in particular. However, we can assume that it probably happened in the early to late 2000s. Test procedure. Place SCP-2077-JP in the testing chamber. A D-class places the test inputs into the top of the shredder and operates the object manually. Input 1, part of the morning edition of the newspaper on the day of the test. Results. Operating noise was produced along with an accurate summary of the contents of each article. In addition, SCP-2077-JP did not shred the parts of the paper with images, and the summaries, avoided mentioning the contents of the images where they were not mentioned in the text. Input 2. Dr. Blank's family photo. Results. Shredded normally with no anomalous operating noises. Input 3. Sheet of white paper the same size as the morning edition of the newspaper. Result. Input shredded normally with no anomalous operating noise. Input. Paper with a list of randomly selected words. Results. Input shredded normally with no abnormal operating noise. Input 5. Stack of computer punch cards used in 19 redacted. Results. Operating noise was produced along with blank sheets of paper of A4 on which there were printed binary code found on the punch cards. Input 6. Text detailing redacted. Results. Operating noise was produced along with data expunged. Input 7. Input 6 encrypted with a substitution cipher. Results. Operating noise was produced along with text detailing redacted, which was identical to the content in input 6. Input 8. An electromagnetic storage device containing input 6 as a text file. Results. Operating noise was produced along with text detailing redacted, which was was identical in content. That was really worded weird. To input 6. Analysis. SCP-2077-JP is capable of shredding anything containing information, even if it is not paper. In addition, SCP-2077-JP is capable of decoding ciphertexts and reading information from digital storage media. During experiment 1, due to defect in blades, an incident in which the test inputs were not shredded occurred. The input that was not shredded in the blades was also not processed by SCP-2077-JP. In view of this, experiments 2 and 3 were carried out on the same day. Experiment 2 involved removing the blades and passing inputs 1 through 8 through SCP-2077-JP. No sounds were produced and no change in observation in the object. Experiment 3 involved replacing the blades with electrically operated shredder blades and passing inputs 1 through 8 through SCP-2077-JP. The same results were obtained as in Experiment 1. As such, it has been determined that SCP-2077-JP's effects only manifest when an object is shredded in it, and that the blades can be replaced with no adverse effect on its anomalous properties. Following this, it was planned to upgrade the blades. Experiment 4. Test procedure. Place SCP-2077-JP in the testing chamber. A D-class connects the object to power and inserts the test inputs into the top of the object. Input 1. Two blank CDSDs, rats, male and female. Results, rat shredded in complete silence. Two CDSD rat genomes were produced. Input 2. A class D's left index finger cut off in an accident. Results, input along with input 1 shredded in complete silence. An accurate human genome was produced. The results of input 1 and 2 required 15 days to fully produce. Input 3. We drew a picta. Basically an ocelot gecko. Shredded silently. An accurate genome of the input organism was produced over the course of 2 days and 10 hours. Input 4. Polychaos dubium, which is an amoeboza. Results shredded silently. An accurate genome of the input organism was produced over the course of 1 year and 213 days. Input 5. An artificial organism with no genetic material. Input shredded normally with no anomalous operating noise. The following experiment 4 test used organic material with a genome larger than that of humans to require was required to have previous approval. There is an addendum here listed as experiment 5, which we will go through now. I'm not abandoning you early. Get in here, it's time for sleepy time. We're doing our sleepy time best, baby. Experiment 5 went as such. Test procedure. Place SCP-2077-JP in the testing chamber. A D-class connects the object to power and inserts the test inputs into the top of the object. Input 1. A replica of the punch cards from Experiment 1. Input 5, 1 through 5. After shredding, designated 1 through 5. Results. Operating noise was produced along with blank sheets of A4 paper on which were printed the binary code on the punch cards identical to the results obtained during Experiment 1. Input 2, 1 through 5, after shredding designated 1 through 5. Results. Operating noise produced along with a source code resulting from decompiling. Input binary code. Input 3. 1 through 5, 2. Operating noise was produced, a text containing the steps for compiling the source code and running the program, as well as an explanation of the programs was produced. SCP-4, 1 through 5, 3. Results, operating noise produced, steps for operating computer and the physical methods of turning the computer on was produced. Input 5. Results of experiment 4, input 2, 4-2. After shredding the designated 4-1. Operating noise produced. The data expunged of the D-class whose left finger had been cut off was produced. In the text, it was mentioned that the D-class had lost his left index finger. Input 6, 4-21. Operating noise produced. A general description of modern humans, such as their features, habits, and habitats, was produced. Input 7, 4-22. Operating noise produced. A document containing data expunged was produced over the course of 21 days. 4-23. Operating noise produced. A document containing data expunged in Hebrew was produced over the course of 7 days. Input 9. 4-4. Shredded. Results. Operating noise produced. A document thought to contain data expunged is currently being produced. Testing on SCP-2077-JP using inputs which the output cannot be easily read predicts and requires the approval of HMCL and O5 Council. So that is an interesting little ditty. About a funky little paper shredder. I am enthralled. See if we've got something neat here. Oh! This one is from the Vietnamese SCP Wiki. And I am interested. I don't think we've gotten one of these before. It's a rock! Ooh! Alright. Item number 096-VN. Containment Class Euclid. Special Containment Procedures. A 250-meter radius perimeter around SCP-096-VN has been set up under the guise of biosphere research. Trespassing individuals are to be detained and amnesticized. In crossed-out text here we have, efforts to develop the land surrounding SCP-096-VN are underway. This has been expunged. And now says no further disturbance to be made around the land surrounding SCP-096-VN. So something must have happened for this to have taken its course down this road. Any deviation from expected behaviors is to be reported to the Department of Mythological Studies. SCP-096-VN was an unmarked gravestone located in Ba Vi National Park in Hanoi, Vietnam. It is roughly 6 meters tall, limestone boulder, with one side carved out, but otherwise lacks prominent distinguishing features. The carved outside has the following inscription. Here lies a moment of his eternity, the one I called my brother. The land surrounding SCP-096-VN is exceptionally fertile, with high bioavailability of key nutrients and accelerated mineralization processes. as well as consistent levels of rainfall contributing towards the flourishing of wildlife in the areas. However, all cultivation attempts thus far have resulted in extreme aggression from the native animal species, and at one point, a sudden rainstorm resulting in two casualties from lightning strikes. Addendum 096.1. Radioscopic imaging of the ground beneath SCP-096-VN revealed a human corpse of high thaumaturgic capacity. Surrounded by many gold and silver ingots, pearl jewels, several dozen elephant tusks, horse skeletons, shark carcasses, mussel shells, and bones of unidentified animals, notably sea-based objects, are positioned more directly in front of the corpse. Shortly after, the following appeared underneath the original inscription: "You have been shaped by belief, then desire, then adversity, prisoner of the words of our children. I did not realize then the destiny laid before us as I rose against him time and time again. I understand now the only eternal regrets and atonement you can find here. The chain is no more. Leave, my brother, be." Foundation personnel immediately retreated without further incident. Special containment procedures have been revised and placed under the oversight of the Department of Mythological Studies. Hi, Percy. Welcome in. We are reading from the International Wiki, so you will likely see some stuff that you haven't seen before. Thank you for the puppet rain. Let me get my little sippy. How you doing, Percy? You having a good night? So, we're hopefully gonna be reading for a while here, so get comfy. Oof, my nose. Oh, this one's from the French Wiki. Ah, I hope you had a good day at work. SCP-004-FR. Threat level yellow, object class safe. Well, I hope to give you some good background noise to write to. Special containment procedures. SCP-004-FR is currently contained in a liquid state, compressed and reduced to two-thirds of its original volume in a 10,000-liter capacity pressure tank. The tank is stored at containment site 004-FR. It must be inspected every month. The least deterioration must be reported and an assessment of risk of explosion established. Depending on the risk, the tank can be changed at the site itself, which will always have a tank ahead of time and necessary equipment to transfer the SCP. Description: SCP-004-FR is a cloud with a cumulus-like appearance. A study of its absorption spectrum indicates that it is normally consisting of condensed water and particles suspended in the atmosphere. It has a constant volume of 15 meters squared. Because of the usual exchanges with the atmospheric medium do not occur, it seems like this cloud does not necessarily follow the direction of the wind and can be moved punctually in different directions. It also tends to remain isolated. Natural fluctuations in presence and temperature do not seem to have a great effect on SCP-004-FR as on other clouds. SCP-004-FR. Oh, that is in French. Oh, this one hasn't been fully translated yet. Oh no. I'm gonna skip the French. I'm sorry. I'm not good at reading French. My French skills are very, very bad. Let me actually turn myself up a little bit so you guys can hear me a little bit better. So I notice my levels are a little low. Direct observation of SCP-004-FR randomly produces hypnotic hallucinations in some subjects. No correlation could be established among all affected and unaffected observers. Only 0.33% of exposed subjects are affected by the effects of SCP-004-FR. Seems that an unaffected subject keeps this status all his or her life and can never be a victim of hallucinations if he or she did not suffer from them in the first exposure. Scope of SCP, the SCP is proportionally to its visibility within the subject's field of vision. Hallucinations vary subject to subject and can be highly variable in nature, intensity, and duration. Victims who have been observed appear mostly amorphous or obnubilated, staring at the clouds. If the duration of hypnosis is long and the cloud moves away, the victims start to walk after the cloud in order to not lose sight of it. If sight is cut off during hypnosis, the victim will find himself deeply disoriented physically, but especially psychologically. This disorientation will last until death of the subject, who will feel lost all throughout their life. Before its discovery, it is very possible that SCP-004-FR caused many accidents to unexpectedly hypnotized vehicle drivers. As many of the subjects came out fundamentally changed and affected by post-traumatic delirium, being able to feel invested with a mission or detached from their body, most of them have no memory of their experiences. You can't join the Discord. I'll have to fix it later. There is a link, I think, in my Twitter. I'll repost it after we're done. Where was I? No memory of their experience, and suddenly come back into contact with the real world. They then quickly make changes in their lives, suddenly seeming more interested in their personal development. Those who have retained memories of their hallucinations have all spoken of the choices they made in their lives, and those they will have to make. The veracity of these predictions is not verifiable, since they concern the choices of the subject that would have to make if they had not lived through this experience. It is therefore impossible to know whether SCP-004-FR effects are vision, external origins, or hallucinations generated by the subject's imagination. No treatment has been found. According to the studies conducted on victims' brains, the effects are irreversible. All victims were placed in psychiatric hospitals. The psychiatric institution, not paying much attention to the kind of speeches they make, is the best place to accommodate victims without the risk of media exposure. The effects of SCP-004-FR probably inspired characters who had data expunged. SCP-004-FR was discovered by Agent Blank. A report was circulating about individuals worshipping a cloud and walking in procession after it. The agent found about 20 people watching the description at Blank in Transylvania. The cloud was located by satellite and tracked. The believers in the cloud were, in fact, following a leader who had been affected by SCP-004-FR using mystical words. He had persuaded the people he met along the way that the cloud would open up the gates of spiritual elevation. When the cloud chose them. Addendum, 5 months after the beginning of containment, similar incidents to those reported of SCP-004-FR. It is possible that the cloud was not the only one, however, Professor Blank wishes to proceed with the decontamination of SCP-004-FR to verify its effects are still effective. The professor's hypothesis is that the properties of SCP are not from the cloud, but from something else. Let me see if I can't help you out here. Because I want to say that the link was still good. Unless I junked up and it's not correct. Thank you. Let me see. That's weird. It did it right. Thank you, Goobies. Goobies got you. Goobie got this. Thank you, Goob. I want to say I had. Hold on. Hold on. I have this right here, and I think this too might also work. I forgot that I added these, but we do have a few different triggered commands that you can put in chat. One of them is for this. Oh no, it's fine. That one should work. I also have one for, just so you know, Goob. I have one for my socials and I have one for Raiders. But like, you know. All right. Now that we've gotten over our little adventure, let me hit the Randall button and we will continue from there. It's almost like I had a setup that I completely forgot about. It's almost like I forgot completely that I had that until I went to double check that I had it. Whoops. Whoops. All right. There is another Vietnamese one. SCP-014-VN. Object glass safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-014-VN should be kept in a safe glass locker. Site 13-VN. Foundation agents must keep track of GOI-386, Dr. Wondertainment, to identify similar anomalous objects. Oh, this is neat. So a little aside, because I always feel the need to talk about this because I love Dr. Wondertainment and is one of my favorite little side entities in the SCP community. Dr. Wondertainment is this interesting little bitty creature who makes these funky anomalies that are usually people or objects that do strange things, and they are so fascinating to me. I love Dr. Wondertainment. And this seems to be a Vietnamese-filmed SCP that is all about Dr. Wondertainment. So let's dig into this. I am invested. I love Dr. Wondertainment. SCP-014-VN is a box of crayons with no trademark printed on the outside of the box other than a purple W at the front. SCP-014-VN displays no anomalous properties when left untouched. Its anomalous properties only manifest when handled by a child between 6 and 11 years old. When a child meeting such criteria draws a picture with the crayons inside the box, SCP-014-VN will allow for all objects in the picture to manifest in reality, including cases when the existence of objects defies non-anomalous scientific rules. These objects will exist in roughly an hour since the picture's completion. After the child finishes drawing said picture, a message will be appearing at the top side of the paper used to draw the picture. The message is presumed to be a commercial for Dr. Wondertainment and reads as follows. The Magical Crayon Box. Dear kids, perhaps each and every one of you has a secret dream for yourself and always want to realize your dreams. But it all seems to be complicated, am I right? Don't worry. Dr. Wondertainment will help you get the job done. With these dream crayons, trademark, your doodles will walk out of your paper and become reality, regardless of how gigantic they are. With this box of crayons, you'll be able to have so much fun wandering in your own imaginative world. So, let's get to your local shop and buy yourself a box of dream crayons, trademark. Right now. Notice to the parents, keep out of little children's reach. This product is only for children between 6 and 11 years old. People with allergies to peanuts should not use the product in any case. Only effective in 1 hour after being used, Dr. Wondertainment promises not to harm your children, but will take any responsibility for casualties resulting in the product being used. guys like my infomercial voice? My side effects reading? Gotta read fast. A theory was raised that SCP-014-VN does not only create objects that appear in the picture, but also rely on the subject's subconscious to realize their wishes. The mechanism that SCP-014-VN uses is still unknown. Experiment log. Logs currently contain information about all experiments pertaining to SCP-014-VN. It's been perfected, very much so. Yes, I'm reading medicine commercials to the side very secretly. You guys don't know it, but when you hear that lovely woman's voice come on the television, she tells you that your medication's going to kill you. It's probably me. It's me. I'm secretly the shoot your brains out until you die lady. I'm so sorry to tell you this. The experiments were conducted at Blank Primary School under the guise of a drawing contest. All subjects and observers participating in the experiments were administered amnestics as per Foundation protocols. I'm built for it. 6 years old. A short-lasting rain. It is a. Let me describe these drawings as we go about them. It is a drawing of a little stick figure. He is holding his arms up in the air. There are blue clouds surrounding him, and from these clouds, there are these little candies and stars that are dripping down. It's raining candy. Phenomenon. A short-lasting rain occurs inside the schoolyard. Candies of various types drop from the sky instead of what regular water drops do. Notes: the amount of candies in the picture and reality are equal. And these candies, I'm making myself tired, can be safely consumed. 7 years old. The picture is of a little guy with a very big mustache. He has a little coat and pants, and he is smiling very, very happy. Yeah, I'm very soothing to myself. And he is surrounded by little hearts. And his little hearts and his little mittened hands. He has two signs held up that both say 10, like he is very, very happy. The subject was happy to receive high grades, is the phenomenon that we got. Notes. Of note is that the subject's studying results are unsatisfactory. Inspection of his school transcript shows that all bad grades have been replaced by excellent grades. Interviews with the subject's teachers revealed that they have no knowledge of such changes. A 9-year-old's drawing. So this drawing is of what I'm going to assume is a little girl and a cat. She is colored pink, and the cat is saying, well. And they are surrounded by these little colored blocks that are quite adorable. It is a very interesting little creature. The phenomenon after the picture's completion, a domestic dog's, so that's not a cat, that is in fact a dog. I don't know the difference between a cat and a dog. Domestic dog, a Fuego Ridgeback breed, spontaneously appeared in the area. It walks in the subject's proximity and attempts to play with her. The subject's homeroom teacher leaves following commentaries on her. Shell usually participates in lessons actively, however, she does not seem to have any friends as she is new to the school. On normal days, she often comes to school's guard booth to play with his dog. So, for brevity's sake, they actually put that they cut out about 30 other experiments just to see, just to lessen the article's impact. I think for study purposes, they should have left that in, but who am I to judge the SCP Foundation? This picture's description, it is a little stick figure riding on the back of a Tyrannosaurus Rex. It is bright green and it has these little diamonds on the back. The stick figure is smiling and happy, and the Tyrannosaurus Rex is angry and pouty. It's very cute. An instance of a Tyrannosaurus Rex appears in the area and destroys the surroundings. However, it does not harm the subject and allows him to ride his back. The species has been extinct for many years. And this one looks like it is from an 11-year-old. Oh, this one's sad. The picture shown here includes two individuals, a mom and a dad outlined in blue and yellow, with their names written beside it. On the father's shoulders is a little stick figure with his name written above it, and he is happily reaching his arms up into the sun. There is a sun in the sky and just smiling. Happy and bright. He is also surrounded by little clouds. The effects of this are two skeletons spontaneously appear to sit down next to the subject sitting between them. The subject's parents had passed away 10 years ago in an accident. And that is the end of SCP-014-VM. That one was a little sad at the end, not gonna lie. That one was a little bit too sad. Ooh. Oh, this one hasn't been translated yet. Oof. Oh, man. I'll have to find another one. So while we wait for the refresh counter to go down, because it does take 60 seconds for the randomizer to do its thing. How are you guys doing tonight? Is everybody having a good time? Let me do my little sippy. My voice is, I'm trying to remain as like low voiced and soothing as I can. I don't do these often, but I'm trying my best. It's better than me yelling. I can't be yelling all night. I can't do it. I can't yell all night. I can try. Give it another few before I try and click this again. It was in Esperanto, and I do not know a lick of Esperanto. I barely know English. I hope everybody's. Well, I'm glad to see that you're enjoying yourself. Oh yeah, I think I'm almost done rigging Poppet. I just have to fix his toggles, and he should be ready to go. Yay! Our Poppet's gonna be fixed. And we get our new baby. Our new baby boy. He's gonna be so cute. I'm so excited. He's very, very adorable. Hold on, I'll give you guys a sneak peek. I can give you guys a sneak peek, I think. Hold on. Don't worry too much. Ooh, breaking your immersion. It's a Poppet. Look at him. He's just a little guy. He's just a little guy. I've gotta fix his little eyebrow there, but he is ready to go mostly. He's just a little dude, just a little friend. Now let me get myself back here. Let me just. Oh, you're not supposed to see that. You're not supposed to see this. This is what I get for breaking immersion. this is what I get for breaking your margin. I want a poppet plush or iris poppet plush. I don't even know what I would do for like an iris poppet. I don't know what that would look like. I have no idea what that would look like. Alright. Okay, so now we got a new one. Two blushes. Alright, now we're on to another one. Let me zoom myself in a little bit here. Yay! Alright. I'm in a little too close. There we go. Now you can see me. So this is SCP-CN-2835, object class safe, container class pending input, threat level 5. So this one is going to be a little bit interesting, I think. Special containment procedures. SCP-CN-2835 is a topological space capable of holding a total of 20 normal adult male humans in total. In addition to several facilities appearing for the beds, the space contains various unknown devices. Some of these devices are connected to the head, to my head, and I am trapped in the room, and I am not allowed to leave. A rhythmic whistling sound can be heard in the interior of the room, coming from an electronic device located at the top left of the bed, connected to the location where my heart is in my chest. SCP-CN-2835-A is a collective designated for 11 humanoids wearing white windbreakers with strange symbols on them consisting of three arrows pointing inwards. Some of the entities constantly ask me about the names of high-ranking individuals in a certain foundation. It seemed disappointed when I elect not to respond. It is suspected that SCP-CN-2835-A come from an enemy faction and are attempting to obtain classified information on a certain foundation through me. SCP-CN-2835-B is a series of color photographs heavily related to SCP-CN-2835-A, displaying images of humanoid entities different in appearance from the 11 SCP-CN-2835-A, but wearing similar clothing. SCP-CN-2835-A constantly show me these entities' photos and repeatedly ask whether I recognize the people in them. When I repeatedly shake my head, they seem disappointed as well. SCP-CN-3835-C is a collective designation for many humanoid entities, all of which are wearing white windbreakers. When they enter SCP-CN-2835, they do not seem to be particularly concerned with me, instead repeatedly adjusting the electronic devices at the head of my bed. Of note is that SCP-CN-2835-C, upon obtaining unknown information from the electronic device, will report some information to SCP-CN-2835-A, using words like five, mister, and dementia in their conversation. It is suspected that SCP-CN-2835-A and SCP-CN-2835-C have a supervisor-subordinate relationship. Even though I am safe and sound within SCP-CN-2835, all necessary nutrition, clothing, and entertainment provided by SCP-2835-C, I still believe I am being confined within the anomaly. This document will be uploaded to the Foundation database in hopes that the Foundation will rescue me. I will succeed. Description pending input. So that one's neat. It's a little self insert thing. Super interesting. So, let's hit us another one. Oh no, we haven't passed the allotted time. Ripperoni. So I guess we'll just unpack this one while we wait for the refresh rate. So it seems like they say five. I'm wondering if this is part of maybe someone in the O5 Council has dementia, or maybe a former O5 Council member, and that's why they're listed as thinking that these people are detriment to them. That'd be one of the only things that I could really think of for this. Of course, I do find it interesting that that it does, in fact, take place within hospital facilities. I'm imagining in such facilities located probably on the SCP Foundation's own research laboratories. I'm not entirely sure where that would be. Obviously, humanoid containment would be your best argument, but I'm not entirely sure. It is a very interesting, different sort of take on it, though. I do love these self-referential recipes. I think that they always have a nice little flair to them. They offer just the slightest bit of interesting information. Wonder, can I be free now? There we go. Oh no! It's all in Tagalog. I don't know Tagalog. I'm pretty sure that's Tagalog. Yeah, that's Tagalog. I don't know Tagalog. Getting a lot of untranslated ones tonight, and I'm wondering if I can't find ourselves something new. Oh man. How about we take a break and go to the regular wiki for just a bit? We'll go to the. Go to the regular SCP wiki just for a bit while we wait. Yeah, we'll switch around for a minute. So we'll go to. Do-do-do. Let me find it. I love the international wiki because I love seeing what other countries put out. But I always find trouble because I sometimes run into days like this where no matter what I seem to run across, it tends to be untranslated. So we'll quickly head over here. We'll read one from the random CP section. Just for the shits and giggles. SCP-537, Object Class Safe. Special Containment Procedure. SCP-537 is to be kept in a soundproof room. No additional containment measures are required, although SCP-537 has requested one poster of the Muppet Movie, weekly dusting and cleaning of its record. Daily 1 hour visits from Foundation personnel. That was denied. Weekly 1 hour to quote unquote converse with Foundation personnel sent to clean its record following cleaning. Under consideration. A vinyl record of the soundtrack from the Muppet Movie. Denied. It can play the entire soundtrack without needing the actual record. Muppet SCP? Description. Recovered from a pawn shop to which it had been reportedly bought by a young man in February of 1980. SCP-537 bears the appearance of completely normal, albeit tattered gramophone with no visible deviations or abnormalities. The vinyl record, SCP-537-2, beneath its needle, has one circular groove that does not move inward. so that the needle never reaches the center of the turntable. The needle will snap back down the moment it is released. SCP-537 is without a doubt intelligent and demonstrates the ability to both see and hear. It is not yet known how. It communicates by playing songs. SCP-537 is able to play any song that can be found on an existing vinyl record and can do so at will. SCP-537 plays songs all the way through and will never interrupt a song unless its needle is forced up, in which case it will resume the song from the point it left off the next time it is able to play music. Forcing SCP-537 to interrupt a song is discouraged, as doing so seems to cause it to become irritated and respond petulantly to testing for up to several days. SCP-537 can raise and lower its needle on its own. It can answer yes or no questions quickly by raising the needle once for yes and twice for no. It moves its needle in a similar fashion to express numbers, usually used to refer to other SCPs. Attempts to teach SCP-537 Morse code as a way of accelerating communications has failed, owing to SCP-537's inability to read or spell. It does not matter what record is on SCP-537's turntable, it can play whichever songs it pleases regardless. It does, however, have a preference to have SCP-537-2, as it seems unable to reset its needle alone and will eventually be unable to continue playing. SCP-537-2, when played on a normal turntable, is blank. SCP-537 appears to enjoy interacting with humans and thoroughly enjoys being interviewed. Its personality is often described as pompous and flamboyant, usually greeting people with "weakumen" from the musical Cabaret, yet distinctly childish. It is prone to tantrums when offended, which usually consist of it playing angry music at maximum volume non-stop until brought back to containment. It seems more trusting of younger employees and treats older people with cautious disrespect. When asked what its favorite song is, SCP-537 invariably responds by playing the Rainbow Connection from the Muppet movie. Document. SCP-537-1, test for special properties in SCP-537-2, performed by Dr. Blank. SCP-537-2 was played in a regular turntable. The record is apparently blank. A vinyl record consisting of one perfectly circular groove along with a needle would travel would make the purpose of this experiment obvious. When given SCP-537 to play, your replica record was, though the replica, I can't talk. When given to SCP-537 to play, though the replica record was identical, SCP-537 apparently realized that it had not been given SCP-537-2 and reacted angrily, raising its needle and refusing to lower it again until it was given its own record back. SCP-537 continues to refuse to communicate with Dr. Blank. SCP-537-2 Experiment 537-043-1. SCP-043 and a second functioning turntable were introduced to SCP-537, overseen by Agent Link. Transcript are as follows. 043 plays track 29. Heavy breathing is heard. Agent Link. He's here now, 537. Say hello. If... This is so weird. 537 plays Wickleman from Cabaret. 043... During song, hello, what's that sound? 537 makes a scratching sound, but continues to play with the men. 043 during song. This is the record player you told me about? Is there a way to shut it up? Agent Blank during song. 537 can't play another song until it finishes what it's playing. 043 during the song. How annoying. Song ends. 043. Right then, that was lovely. I'm just supposed to converse with you, so how are you, I suppose? Hi! Welcome in, TV boy. How are you doing? I hope you're enjoying your night. We are just simply reading more SCP articles. See. 537 begins playing Sunshine, Lollipops, and Rainbows by Leslie Horne. 043, oh, wonderful. Song ends. 043, right. Let's talk about me then. Is there something you want to know about me? SCP raises and lowers its needle, denoting an affirmative answer. And what would you like to know? 537 begins playing Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles during the song. Why are you playing that? What do you think I. SCP-537 raises its volume. 043, inaudible under the music. Song ends. 537 immediately begins playing the same song again. 43 shouting during the song, "Stop it! Stop it!" 537 raises the volume. 043 shouting during the song, "Data expunged." 043 removed from the room as per its own request. Break. Our chill vibes. I can't help but not laugh. This record player bullied the other record player into shutting the fuck up. It's all gone horribly wrong. Okay, googly moogly, it's all gone shit-kabo. SCP-043 unsurprisingly was not willing to discuss its reaction to SCP-537, simply referring to it as that cheeky thing and mentioning that it's the type that needs to learn to be careful if it doesn't want to data expunge. What is this record player saying? I love it. Oh, this is probably going up there as one of my new favorite SCPs if I had to like put them on a platter. That is adorably amazing. Document 537-2, experiment 537/043-2. 043 was placed after reluctantly agreeing to do so under SCP-537's needle. When asked about how it was feeling, SCP-537 played the first 8 tracks of the White Album by the Beatles. It should be noted that it is unusual for SCP-537 to play a song on the record it is turning, let alone several songs in proper order. After the 8th track, rather than the record stopping or Revolution 9 playing, the record began to skip. A loud noise described as somewhere between a record scratch and a shriek was heard and did not stop until the needle was forced up. SCP-043 refused to speak of the incident, saying only that it never wanted to be near SCP-537 again. SCP-537 reacted similarly when asked its opinion of SCP-043 or 043 responded by playing George Carlin's routine, "Seven Words You Can Never Say on Television." They're fighting. They hate each other. Addendum A. Since experiment 537-043-2, SCP-537 has flatly considered and refused to play any song by the Beatles, responding each time by raising and lowering its needle twice. Asked multiple times to do so, SCP-537 reacted angrily to Dr. Blank. Addendum B. Speculation as to whether or not SCP-537 is capable of playing songs from vinyls released after its construction, the date of which is unknown, has been settled as of a recent interview, which it ended by playing Caring is Creepy from Oh Inverted World by The Shins, an album released on vinyl in June of 2004. This is interpreted as SCP-537's way of expressing apathy towards the interview. That was a fun little one. I like this. I like this funky record player. He's so sassy. SCP-537, my new beloved. Wow. I am keeping him handy. So I can show people him. That is amazing. All right. We are gonna go back to the regular, our regularly scheduled broadcast. And we're gonna go back to the International Wiki. Promise it's fine. This one's untranslated too. So we're gonna switch gears, I think. And we're just gonna go back to the regular SCP Wiki for the rest of the stream. Because this is like third time that that has happened. We have a joke, SCP, everybody. I gotta read it. SCP-4002-J. Object class Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-4002-J is stored in an anti-freeze door. In refreeze door in Dr. Jack's office on Site 19. The office is the Perfetta location to store the object. It is located on level B4, 30 meters underground. In case of a containment breach, all communications are to be cut off to prevent further contamination. This is the worst, and I'm so sorry that you have to deal with it, but as we wait for the refresh, I'm so sorry that I have to read these terrible ones to you at this time of night. This Gippsland SCP-4002-J refers to a cheese wheel of unknown comportion. When observed, the suspect is overwhelmed with the impulse to utilize dear eccentric Cheddarick as a priority in their speech gesture patterns. This effetta has been doffed fine as a mimetic, and as such, containment must be administered carefully. No personnel clearance level 3 or below are permitted to access SCP-4002-J at any time. Spread of effetta of SCP-4002-J. A minority of cases involved a string of dairy rhetoric being persevered by an unaffected subject. Due to the result of linguistics collapse, Mobo Task Force Feta 9, have at the Havarti, is deployed, weigh the situation, and administer amnesics when possible. If the containment procedure has been breached by the 48 hours mark, the effetta is considered to be at pre-medical condition, and infected subjects must be terminated. Oh, goodness. Oh, I have logs. I have logs. I have logs to read. Yeah, get my cheese puns raring to go here. SCP-4002-Day was recovered ailed on a dairy farm in Blank, Wisconsin, following reports on a massive outbreak of cheese-induced ergonments. Unaware of the effetas, the recovery team was exposed to the nemeritic hazard. The team was later graded for their amateur job in the field, and a saga signed a provolone cleaning crew for the week. This document is highly classified. It is not to go to pasteurize. On further study, the effeta of SCP-4002-J goes beyond our initial conjecture. The current decurrentation merely skims the surface of the object's true nature. Over time, the cheese grows exponentially until speech with lactose of dairy saturations becomes unfeasible. As the object pioneers a hozerone of infection, its effeta extends beyond cheese and encompasses the whole dairy. It is now apparent that we have no way of containing SCP-4002-J as it approaches this point. What Gouda of Resiltor against a mimetic plague, I must formally recommend the object be neutralized to avoid a linguistic descent into utter chaos. Okay, I'm done with the cheese puns. We can leave now. Okay. We've got a serious one now. I'm so sorry that I subjected you guys to cheese puns. Please don't hate me. I love you. You love me too, right? Alrighty. Back on the actual grind. As is standard in this fucking house. Item 7110, level 4, secret. Containment class, Euclid. Description class, Eki. Risk class, Notice. So, before we continue, our disruption class, Eki, is different than what we have discussed before, and I am going to really fast look it up. This is actually a term that I am personally unfamiliar with. It must be a newer term that was added to the lexicon not too often long ago. Which means that now my SCP-101 video is out of date. Unfortunate. So, Eki means high potential to disrupt the general population. So, this is kind of a widespread sort of SCP that would get along very easily. Maybe it's even mimetic. Let's see. Assigned site 250. Research head Aaron Eckerson. Assisting research Maria Johnston. Assisting task force Omega 45 Street Samurai. Special containment procedures. SCP-7110-1 is to be kept within its chamber on the 7th sublevel. The Tokyo Imperial Palace. MTF Iota 54 Headhunters is to work in conjunction with the palace staff to guard the chamber for any potential intruders. Officially, the 7th sublevel does not exist and is closed to tourists or non-essential personnel. Any who wander down to the 7th sublevel without permission are to be detained and amnesticized. SCP-7110-1 is not to leave Tokyo city limits during testing and under no circumstance is an SCP-7710-2 instance to be summoned without O5 approval. Description. SCP-7110 is a phenomenon that occurs when SCP-7110-1 is removed from Tokyo city limits. SCP-7110-1 is a... Oh shit, Waffy! Hi, everybody! Welcome! Oh my goodness! Hi! I'm Iris. It's good to see you. I'm a little techno demon. I live in your Wi-Fi. You scared me. Welcome in, everybody. Waffy raid. Hold on, let me give you a little shout out, Waffy. Or no, it's slash shout out. Whoops. Let's shout out Waffy, everybody. We love Waffy in this house. Oh wait. Oh no. Wrong waffle. No, shit, I fucked it up. Damn it. Shit. You spooked me. You fucked me up, Waff. You know what? It's fine. That other person gets a shout out too. I have to wait. Damn it, it's all out of shit. Welcome in, everybody, for Chill SCP Night. We are just simply vibing. I'll shout you out at the end of the stream. God damn it. Get my little sippy. You guys scared me. Welcome in. We're reading some SCP articles tonight. We're just chilling out and winding down for the evening, so feel free to get comfy and relax. This is bedtime story zone. So sit back, enjoy, relax, get cuddled up. I hope you guys had a good day. What'd you stream off? What'd you do? Hello, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the Iris. I hope you have a wonderful evening with us. All right. Let's get back to where we were. I think we were at the description sentence for this, or the start of the description section. Mario and Luigi. Ooh. I love that. Hell yeah. It's playing Omori first, but then I switched to that. I need to finish Omori. I really do. I kickstarted it. I should probably finish it. SCP-7110 is a phenomenon that occurs when SCP-7110-1 is removed from Tokyo city limits. SCP-7110-1 is the skull of Tera no Masakado, a samurai from the 10th century. Facial reconstruction on the skull compared to both his living descendants and historical depictions confirms the object's identity. When SCP-7101 is removed from its chamber, human levels across Tokyo graveyards begin to increase. This continues linearly. I can't talk now. You got me all flustered. Damn it, I can't speak words. I'm trying to read all fancy and shit, but my words have failed me. Oops. If SCP-7110-1 is removed from Tokyo's municipal borders, an instance of SCP-711-0 is formed from a reality shift caused by human disturbance. You done spooked me. So done. SCP-7110-2 is a large skeleton known in Japanese folklore as Gashadokuro, with a height ranging anywhere from 3 to 0.6 centimeters tall or kilometers tall. The appearance of such an entity would more than likely cause a lifted veil scenario. SCP-7110-2 will then travel to Kyoto, where it will proceed to destroy the city and kill its inhabitants until SCP-7110-1 is returned to its chamber. The SCP-7110-2 instances will thus dematerialize. So here we see that big, scary skeletons can, in fact, introduce themselves to the world around you. Yeah, a spooky skull in a basement. I do find these ones interesting. Kind of like the, there was one a while back that we read that was pretty interesting about the little girl with the cow's head that was living in a research facility outside of Tokyo that formed some sort of memetic effect that only really affected. I'll have to find that one again. It was very interesting, very intriguing. I feel like this one could probably play really well into it. These Japanese SCPs really do hit different. Discovery. SCP-7110's chamber was discovered on April 28th of 2022, as Imperial record keepers discovered a never-before-found missive penned in Emperor Hirohito. Spuddy Boyo, thank you for the follow! Welcome to the Iris! I hope you're having a wonderful night! So many new friends! Emperor Hirohito to Lieutenant Colonel Ryusuke Sakamoto of the Ijameya, I think, says here, is the Imperial Japanese Anomalous Matters Explanatory Agency. To briefly read our little narrative here, there is a note attached which gives us a good look into what we are reading. Dear Colonel Sakamoto, I've reviewed your proposal to use the skull that was recently unearthed beneath the palace as a countermeasure against Americans on Operation Kitsko. After careful consideration, I am going to deny your request, and by decree, I will have the chamber resealed. I am not willing to sacrifice one of our greatest cities and its history to destroy the enemy. By the end of this war, I had hoped that there would be a Japan left standing. Even if I believed in the myths you speak, we have no idea what this can control, if this can control the yokai, and that it wouldn't lay the entirety of Hokkaido to waste. We will just have to explore other options. Your Imperial Majesty, Emperor Showa. So interesting, that means that this was probably fully discovered. It says 2022. Oh, I see. This was written during World War II, but the chamber itself was discovered in 2022. So it is a very fresh and new SCP. Let's see. Accompanying the missive were the building plans that showed a hidden chamber on a previously undiscovered sublevel. Foundation agents embedded the palace followed the excavation closely for signs of potential anomalous activity. Once the chamber was found, it was determined to be thaumaturgically sealed and unable to be opened by conventional means. Containment procedures were drafted pending object classification, and Iota 54 was deployed to work with palace staff to keep the chamber guarded until the guise of a potential breach of national security could be lifted. On June 6th, pending the decision of the O5 Council on opening the sealed chamber door, members of GOI 4586, says Japanese branch, raided the Imperial Palace with the intent of opening the chamber. Foundation agents promptly secured the royal family and informed Site 250 of the situation. MTF Omega 45 was deployed to handle the situation as the squad and their handler, Maria Johnston, were visiting Site 250 for exercises. So we've got a little bit of intrigue, a little bit of political, little political, little interest. I do find these ones very fascinating. I do like the ones that work actual history in because I feel like it gives them that little nugget of sensibility, believability. You read stuff like this, and you're like, oh, that's interesting. Could that have happened? Personally, like one of my favorite things about these. Mega 45 personnel listed were John Cassington, squad leader, Cole Marcus, Peter Rickards, SCP-7261-1, aka Michaela Avarella, Valkyrie Unit A4 codename Elestris. Special. So, this is going to be a quick read off of the log itself. I think most of these names are going to be shortened. There's JCCM, PRMA, and AO4. So, we will be reading, and I will just give them their shorthand designations instead of saying their full names. So, JC, Johnston, we're approaching Palastores. Everyone's been evacuated from the complex, yes? Johnston, the building is believed to be clear of civilians. Quails hot, ladies and gentlemen. Treat anything you find in there as hostile. JC, copy that. Marcus and Rickards, secure the doors. Marcus and Rickards take up points on the step and the glass of the sliding doors to the palace. CM, reception seems clear, Commander. Although I have to say, I heard the palace. I was expecting a big grand castle. This just kind of looks like some fancy designer's wet dream. MA. Harley was cool. John, there is something wrong here. This place smells off. JC, what do you mean by off? MA, I smell something non-human. Like Speculum may have brought an anomaly with them. JC noted. Avarella? Everyone with me. JC raises weapons, and all members of Omega 45 enter the reception hall of the palace. The lights are still on, and the room appears to be empty. JC, room is clear, Johnston. No signs of spook or unfort. I don't know how to say that word. Speculum. You want us to sweep the facility? Johnston, that is a negative, JC. Please proceed into the seventh basement sublevel. According to reports, Quilt has stored in the building and made a beeline for the lower levels. That's where you'll find them. MA, guess we finally know what they've been searching for in Hokkaido. But this isn't their usual MO, threatening a Japanese royal family. Way too big even for them. AO4, small fry, always tries to punch above the weight class. Perhaps they're searching for something below. MA, the 9 of 9. JC, enough hypothesizing, you two. Johnston, where's the elevator? Pass reception into the back. This is a really long log. This log is so long. We're gonna skip most of this log. We'll just say that it's been secured properly, with minimal effort. I am very lazy tonight. I don't feel like reading these really long, strange logs. I've read enough of them when we did our little romp into the we did our little romp into the bodies in the water. So we will continue. Following the palace raid, the object they found was subsequently designated SCP-7110, and all efforts to translate Taniguchi's level, somebody who was mentioned in the log that we did not read fully. Any witnesses in the surrounding area of SCP-7110-2 manifestation were amnesticized, and a cover story was created to explain it as an optical illusion due to lighting conditions. Addendum 7110-1. Journal entry translations. So I'm going to read a handful of these journal entries. There are a chunk of them, but I will read some of them out for you guys. Just so we have them handy. Journal recovered from the scene of the June 6th raid on the Imperial Palace. It's confirmed as belonging to Masahiro Taniguchi, a member of the yet unnamed GOI, currently designated as GOI 712 by lead researcher Erickson. Erickson had been investigating other documents by this group prior, and thus was able to translate the journal, which appears to be a collection of letters written by Taniguchi to another member of his organization, Takahiro. Any relevant information was then forwarded to Site 78 to assist in their containment operations. Get some rest! Have a good night, Jack. Take care of yourself. I love you, bud. Stay safe. Get some good work done, my friend. Takahiro, I am sad to be the bearer of news, but Lord Masakado's rebellion has been quelled, and the Lord has been slain in combat. I know our organization was hoping that a new government under his rule would be more favorable to us, but luck was not on our side. To make matters worse, my paramour Satsuki has gotten into her head that she would be able to revive her father, Lord Masakado, with her magic. I told her that such spells are forbidden and that their use would lead to ruin, but she wouldn't listen. I thank the heavens her efforts were for naught, but now she's absconded to a nearby temple to become a shrine maiden. I wasn't able to convince her to stay with me. I do hope she manages her grief enough to return to me someday. I will keep you informed on any developments. Brother Takahiro, I come to you not to relay news, but to gather others of our ranks to stand against a new evil spread in our lands. Takeyashihime has returned from her expedition to Mount Fuji and visited me in the night, but what came to my door was not my Satsuki. Her eyes had blackened and her hands were covered in some type of black rot that was making her way up her arms. Takeyasha's voice was now ethereal and spoke with a commanding presence. She begged me to join her as she was gathering what was left of her father's men to form a rebellion. Truth be told, any other day I would have joined, but I sensed the woman standing in my house, which is a pale imitation of the woman I loved. She's been corrupted by that tome. A black and gnarled book with parchment as withered as its appearance. On its cover, there were markings, a vertical line, and a cross next to it. The pages she showed me contained all manners of necromancy and forbidden spells by the organization. Perhaps even the kami themselves. She said she would use it to create a great yokai. Gashidokuro, using her father's skull to destroy the Kyoto government once and for all. I wouldn't stand for it. I told her to leave and forget these dreams of rebellion, that if she even loved me, she'd burn that forsaken book and come live with me again. Takeyahime merely laughed at my suggestion, said that I didn't understand the pain she was feeling, and that she would accomplish her father's dreams by any means. Should have struck her down right there, brother, though I couldn't. My love for her was just too strong, but I promise you this. When we find her, my blade will strike her true. Fortunes are upon us, Brother Takahiro. Our riders made it to the village of Shibasaki, and the great Gashidokuro has disappeared. I have arrived in my village to oversee the construction of the tomb that the locals can visit to pay their respects to Lord Masakado, as well as have it sealed in the event dark forces would seek to steal its remains. As far as the cursed tome goes, it hasn't been seen since we cast it in the sea. Magics we placed on it ensure that no one should be able to open it, at least without powerful magic. I do hope that this is the last tragedy that the book befalls. Even though my love is now being hailed as a traitor, I know in my heart she only had the noblest of intentions in mind. That's how that foul book preys on you. To be humans are not meant to live forever. Undeath is a power so wicked that no mortal should be able to wield it. We're trapped in life and death is a curse of its own. And that is the end of SCP-7110. Which is interesting. The concept is very neat. I do think that the idea of a skull that can summon a giant spooky skeleton monster is very fascinating. I do have to say, I'm not entirely... There's a lot of stuff added in there that I think is really interesting. I like the angle of it having been created a very long time ago. I like the angle of it being a reoccurring issue. Not entirely sure what I think about it in general, but I think it's a neat little concept. Get a sip of water. Stay hydrated. We have time for... I think I can do one more before we hit the 2-hour mark and I decide to call it here. We got a little bit of time. I think we'll do another random just for the shits and giggles of it, because I love doing my random SCPs. And let's hit that button. Let's see what we get this time. Ooh, and this one's a chunky one. So we should, in theory, be able to get this one going. This will be our last long one for the evening before I head off and go to Sleepy Town. But I am so glad that you guys stayed with me and talked with me this entire time. I love you guys. I am certain that we will be doing this again. I know I've been kind of lax on my SCP streams as of late. I haven't been doing them as much, but I love doing this and we'll be doing it again for sure. I love doing it. It's good. It's very good. All right. So let us jump into our final SCP of the night. You know I love that chill shit. We're probably, I think Friday, I'm going to forego making dinner because I usually cook on my days off from work. I think Friday I'm going to forego making dinner and we're going to have just a very long Wizards 101 stream. Which should be fun. I love playing Wizards. Wizards 101 has been my beloved for like the past little while and I am enamored with its presence. I love card game Wizards. So much fun. All right. Need more fizzle, big fizzles. Big fizzle hours. All right. So, item SCP-6630. Object class Keter, level 4 of 6630 classified. Special containment procedures. Following the events of 9/10/1999, all tracking contain. Hold on, I got something in my throat. Oopsie daisies. Hold on. Lube it up before I start talking. All right. Following the events of 09/10/1999, all tracking containment and long-term research of the effects of SCP-6630 have been allocated and classified by the newly formed Foundation Fire Suppression Department. Description: SCP-6630 is a predatory life form resembling fire. While visually and functionally it is similar to baseline combustion, producing both heat and light, SCP-6630 can be recognized for the following differences. Have a good night, Percy. Take care of yourself. Have a good evening. Thank you for the puppet rain. Sleep well. Get some rest. I hope you have a good rest of your night. A slight downward curl of topless flames, a separation in uniformity of the middle flames. Slats or paper-like fans, and a total lack of combustion in the substances or structure of SCP-6630 is feigning to burn. Wait a minute. Oh, I'm actually not gonna rate this one. I just realized what it is. And maybe, you know what? No, we've read worse things. We've read worse things. Let's do it. When presenting itself as an ordinary fire, SCP-6630 will hover closely to a mock fuel source until its intended prey species approaches. I think I read this wrong. I think we're fine. This isn't what I thought it was. I thought this was going to be a jet fuel can't melt steel beam sort of thing, and I did not want to go through that. After the holes incident with the last time that we had an SCP reading, I don't want to go through it again. Prey includes nesting social animals relying on more nuanced behaviors regarding fire, i.e., approaching fire for warmth or extinguishing fire to protect their home/kin. Once in proximity, SCP-6630 will utilize further allurement, ambush, and aggressive tactics to ensure successful latching onto its prey. After the like multiple holes incident that we had last time, I'm a little wary of some of these SCPs. Some of them are a trick. Some of them are a trick to get me to say weird things aloud. SCP-6630 can only and will only immolate living creatures. This quote-unquote feeding process is exceptionally slow relative to ordinary combustion, lasting hours to full days, depending on the prey's total body mass. The presence of fuel-rich organic sources, such as fats and waxy follicles, do not appear to influence SCP-6630. Instead, SCP-6630 will only stop feeding and latching once its prey has completely ceased all life functions. During feeding, SCP-6630 will ignite as much of the epidermis as possible to a bright, hot, and soundless intensity. The prey's own pained vocalizations and movements, coupled with light and heat, will then draw in other prey seeking to avoid or extinguish. While ordinary immolation causes living creatures to experience rapid basalvic syncope, aka passing out from pain, SCP-6630 appears capable of maintaining prey consciousness for 30 to 40% of its feeding time, totaling up to multiple hours. Once its prey is fallen unconscious, however, SCP-6630 will diminish into a low smolder and burn the body of the targeted sections. This behavior both maximizes feeding time and entices further prey to snuff out SCP-6630 while it appears less dangerous. These efforts will universally fail. No known method exists to extinguish SCP-6630. Unlike normal, ordinary combustion, it does not require oxygen or heat to function, only a living fuel source. As such, water, halon, and other conventional forms of fire suppression have proven entirely ineffectual against SCP-6630. Addendum: Containment Failure. SCP-6630 instigated a breach event utilizing a previously unseen capacity to reduce its energy output to near totally, planting a single ember into the inseam of L2 maintenance worker N. Leeds' hazard suit and avoiding thermal imaging detection. The subsequent spread of SCP-6630 resulted in the deaths of 198 Foundation personnel. It has been officially noted that all survivors of Site-96 were safeguarded by the quick thinking and coordination of L3 engineer Henrietta Boone, sealing herself and 18 co-workers inside an unoccupied anomaly containment cell until SCP-6630 fully depleted its fuel sources. She's been awarded with the Foundation Star. The following information is restricted to FSD internal affairs. Unauthorized access is strictly forbidden. If you have access to the section without authorization, close your session and remain where you are. We know how to find you. So, Henrietta Boone, SL01, recording digital pump, dental therapy session. So this is a log of everything that Miss Henrietta has been going through for the time being. I am going to say, for the fact that this is the last one for the night, I will read this one in full since I find it a little bit more interesting than the last one. Henrietta, how are you sleeping? Fine. Henrietta Boone, SL02, surveillance footage, home bedroom, 21/12/1999. 3:24 a.m., Henrietta Boone sits in the corner holding her knees and staring at the bedroom door. Digital recording of confidential therapy session, 22/12/1999. And the nightmares? No, not recently. Surveillance footage of home bedroom, 21/12/1999. 4:36 a.m. Henrietta Boone, having fallen asleep in the corner, wakes up suddenly and throws a lamp at the bedroom floor. Fuck you. I won't let you in. Fuck you. Stop screaming at me. Henrietta Boone sinks back down into the floor. Digital recording of confidential therapy session, 22/12/1999. And you've been taking your medication, saying your daily affirmations, meditating. They haven't updated the document. Pardon me? The document about the fire, 6630? They haven't updated it. I sent them another revision packet last night. Henrietta, we discussed this. The archivist will update the listing when I just mean mechanically speaking. Shouldn't they mention that 6630 can burn underwater? Or that it can burn so hot, so quick, and so precisely that it can melt a bullet heading towards someone's head? Or Henrietta? Or that? Hey, how about the fact that 6630 can't coexist with real fire? That the only way to actually help someone that's been burning to death for hours and hours is by setting them on fire? Because we learned that the hard way, didn't we? Shouldn't they put that in the damn document? Henrietta, stop. 3 seconds of silence follow. What you're experiencing is called retroactive compensation. It's a common response from those suffering from survivor's guilt, especially problem solvers like yourself. You want to fix all the issues that caused the original trauma. You can't. Though it happened, you need to accept that and start moving forward. Yeah, but look around. What am I moving forward from? Everyone who survived is acting like it never happened. I see them every day, sitting in the break room, laughing over coffee, walking through the same hallways. Now that all the soot and people resin is gone, nothing has changed. 198 people died, and nothing changed. They just brought in more people. I feel like I'm going crazy here. They won't even update the damn document. Henrietta, I know you're looking for some immediate external validation when... No. You know what? You're totally right, Riva. I need to move forward, How long have I been stuck down there designing monster cages, huh? How can I expect anything to change when I'm still in the exact same place? I'm a problem solver, yeah? I'm an engineer. A problem is a problem until I fix it. I see, and how do you intend on doing that? Step one, I leave this office. And step two? I just leave. Report, Henrietta Boone has submitted her resignation to HR. Response, offer grade 1 benefits package, bonus at 15% updated wages. Henrietta Boone has refused grade 1 benefits. Response, grade 2 benefits package, bonus at 20% wages, new title. Henrietta Boone has empathetically refused grade 2 benefits. Response, begin targeted life improvements. Approve all site transfer, offer expense paid vacation. Henrietta Boone, SL06, email to the Foundation, 52-2000. Dear whoever isn't getting the message, I quit. Thank you, Dr. Henrietta Boone, Containment Cell Engineer, Sector, formally. Report, Henrietta Boone has left Site 96. Response, engage stimulus protocol, furlough. Henrietta Boone, email to Dennis White, 52-2000. Hey Dennis, it's been a while. How's Kendra? How's the kid? Sorry I couldn't be there for her christening, I was buried in work. Makes you long for those days of U of A, huh? At least those all-nighters were followed up with beer and board games, not just more work. So it goes. So listen, work is actually why I'm contacting you. Not that I don't miss you, Fuzzy Boy. I'm just kind of in a bind. I'm looking for a new posting for the first time in a long while, and it seems like the job market is really rough. The economy must be in some terrible shape right now, and I remember your consulting firm. And not to brag or anything, but I think I could be a big asset. How'd you feel having missed top class on your team, huh? Oh, forget U of A. Oh, what the fuck?
Hold on.
Did you guys hear that? What the fuck? Hold on, just seems like the ghost is getting upsetties that I'm talking in here. That was fucking weird. I don't even know what fell. It sounded like something fell. What the fuck? I'm just gonna ignore that and get back. No, I. Okay, so I'm not crazy. I think that might be the first time that I've got ghosty on voice. I'm gonna have to go back and see if you guys if we can hear that. That's wow, ghosty. That spooked me. Okay, we'll finish this SCP. I'm gonna go back into the VOD afterwards, and I'm gonna see if I can't find that. No, okay, if you heard it, then that's good. No, I only reacted after I heard the noise I was talking. Wow. Love Ghosty, my best friend. Wow. Wasn't expecting that to happen on stream. All right. We'll go back through the VOD. I'll pop back through the VOD and see if I can't catch it and post it on Twitter or something. That scared the shit out of me. Holy shit. Yeah, I can't clip it, so you have to. I'm intrigued. I'm gonna find it. What time was this? We're about 2 hours and 8 minutes in, so it's probably like 2 hours and 5 minutes in. I'll see if I can clip it. That was crazy. Damn. Okay. Wow. That spooked the shit out of me. Okay, we'll finish this SCP up, and then I'll go ghost hunting. Holy shit. I can't believe that happened on stream. That's crazy. Where I can fetch some coffee, I'm not that proud. Honestly, I wouldn't say this to anyone else, but I'm getting a little worried. I didn't expect to be looking for work this long. Let me know, okay? Message me back. Or just accept my NSM. My MSN friend request dummy, Boone. Port Simulus Protocol furlough success, 119 engineering applications rejected, 43 consulting applications rejected, 31 civil labor applications rejected, 24 retail applications rejected, 5 temp work agency applications rejected, subjects financial savings continue to diminish, employment response is not changing. Gain stimulus protocol coverage. Phone message from Joanna Boone. 6/14/2000. Hey Henry, it's Joe. Sorry to call you out of the blue like this. Mom let me know about your job. Sorry. I know you'll land black on your feet. You were always the smart one, so I hate to ask this really. You know I do. But well, Tom and I need your help. My medical benefits have been canceled. The company said something about new management? Or something about switching providers? We're supposed to get back soon. Well, Tom still isn't walking right after the accident, even though the doctors say his shin should have healed by now. His masters at the construction site said it was his fault, but that fucking chain did not come loose. It snapped. It snapped. But now his unemployment is about to run out. We've got a mortgage, and we're trying for a baby this year, and. God, Henry, I'm sorry. These messages are only supposed to be like a minute, right? Listen, I know you've got your own problems, right? I know in this economy it's in terrible shape. Just give me a call. Love you, sis. Stimulus protocol coverage success. Subject has transferred funds to Joanna Boone. Subject's finances continue to deplete. No change in employment response, but subject shows promising levels of anxiety and second guessing. Recommended escalation. Response engage, stimulus protocol insolvent. Phone conversation with Foundation emergency line, 11:14, 2000. 14 seconds of chirps and beeps as Foundation disruption software answers no recording or tapping or tracing. Operation. Or operator. Good afternoon, Miss Boone. How can we help you? Oh, hey, how's it going? Well, let's see. Can you tell me why my fucking bank account is empty? I'm afraid this is an emergency line, Miss Boone, reserved for dire. The fact that I can't pay my heating bill and it's negative 10 degrees outside is a big fucking emergency, thank you. Now, I know this was you. You've been fucking with me ever since I left the Foundation. But this is too goddamn much. Give me my money back. I'm terribly sorry, Miss Boone, but it's not your money. We never paid you. Like, fucking excuse me? You see, the Foundation is not formally incorporated institution, Spoon. We operate out of multi-layered front corporations to provide all our hardworking employees with traceable legal tender, which is an unfortunately extremely costly and delicate process. Of course, the Foundation has been more than happy to validate your unsanctioned finances for more than 2 years while you looked for another position. But it's money. I earned it working for you. That's correct. You earned it working for us. The shadow organization no one knows exists. You can't just take my money away. As I said, Miss Boone, it wasn't actually your money. You see, we preserve normalcy, maintain the veil, and protect the whole wide world. Foundation must retain entirely insular. When you worked for us, you were given an employment conditional stipend, which is really more like money lending. No, you know what? Fuck you. Fine. I'm done with this. I don't need your damn money. Just let me get another job and move the fuck on. With the Foundation would never interfere with an ex-employee's future career aspirations, Miss Boone. We're very sorry to hear you're having a difficult time finding a new position. We know the economy is in terrible shape right now. Now, if you consider rejoining the Foundation team, we have some wonderful positions available in... Loud cracking noise, later identified as Miss Boone throwing her phone across the room. Distorted sobbing. Call disconnects. Stimulus protocol insolvent. Success. Recommended stimulus protocol wasting. Salted Earth Judas in total crisis for escalation. Response standby. Henrietta Boone, Observation Blue Park Meadow, 13-12-2000. Henrietta Boone sits on a park bench. Visibility is limited due to an active snowstorm. Henrietta Boone is observed shivering heavily as she's wearing only a thin jacket. Henrietta Boone makes no attempts to sand or seek shelter. Record Purge, wearing only a plain suit, enters the east path and sits down next to Henrietta Boone. Henrietta Boone looks at Record Purge in confusion and caution. You should head back inside. What the fuck? There's no fucking way. There's no fucking way that that's happened twice tonight. That one you guys probably didn't hear, but I heard a loud bang on my wall. Yeah, I heard a bang on my wall. 2:14? Thank you. We're timestamping paranormal activity. Oh my god. I'm fine, thank you. Excuse me. Henrietta Boone stands and begins to walk away. Sit down, Miss Boone. Henrietta Boone freezes. She looks back at Record Expunged. I've gotta go back to Hans. I'm gonna base boost this shit. She slowly resumes her seat. Record Expunged offers her a cigarette. Somebody just went in the bathroom, so that's normal. So you're here to kill me? Record Purge looks at the cigarette and laughs. Record Purge lights it and begins smoking. Then, who are you? Oh, hell, that doesn't matter. I'm just here to deliver a message. I'm not coming back. Record Purge exhales a lungful of smoke, then rests his arm over the back of the bench. You know, the people I work for, name's not important. They got two kind of playbooks. There's a white playbook and a black playbook. You blazed right through the white playbook when you just up and quit. Determined. Most people deliberate on it longer. Fuss around with the idea. There's plenty of time to get in there. And what? Torture them? Record Expunge shakes their head while taking another drag. No. White playbook first. That's 90% of our job, actually. We remind people why working for the Foundation is the best job in the world. Half the pay bumps come down from our department because the right people are worth it. That's our motto. Someone gives their 2 weeks. In 13 days, we've made their lives so damn good they don't even remember why they were quitting. Not just their work life either. No. We solve all sorts of problems, financial frustrations, personal problems, bedroom issues, you name it. Record Purge looks at the cigarette and then stamps it out on the bench board. But some of them, like you, just don't want to be happy working in a secret lab, saving the world, earning three times as much money as they'd earn anywhere else. Then we've got to break out the black playbook. Is that what this is? Are you're here to threaten me? No, I'm here because I've been watching you, Miss Boone. You seem like a smart person. It's a refreshing idea with scientists, you know. You'd think they'd be smart people. They're scientifically. It's people, though. They're mostly idiots. They spend their lives in books and labs and free research projects, never learning any common sense or social smarts. Migratory creature scientists. They don't stay still very long. They move from project to project, patent to patent, grant to grant, years, tenure, herding cats. Hey, look around the foundation. What do you see? 30, 40, 50 years, tenure. All working to keep the world safe. That's because somebody like me brought them back when they went feral. You, though. Practical woman like you. I figured it might be worth going off playbook and just telling you direct. I am not coming back. Record Purge sighs, brushing snow off their knees. Miss Boone, I am not here to threaten you. I want you to understand that the black playbook for yours is a novel. You'd only be on chapter 3. Trying a very light touch with you till now. Oh, yeah? Starving me, freezing me, gouging my family's medical benefits? It's just foreplay for you people? Yes. Let me put it another way, Miss Boone. I see days like this. A man with a bad shin like your brother-in-law might end up slipping while snow blowing his driveway. Your forgetful mother might window open after she's done airing out the kitchen and taking a nap on the couch. Wind up having a long, cold sleep. And those are just conventional hazards. We've seen firsthand what kind of monsters there are in this world. You help pen them up once in a lifetime. Without you, well, one of those monsters might end up making a home in your niece's bed. Right, your sister hasn't told you yet. Congratulations. Fuck you. Fuck you. Record Purge sighs, stands, and straightens their suit. Take however long you'd like, Miss Boone. Swear at our phone operators, endanger your life, spray paint our logo on your car, and drive around screaming about the foundation. It won't change anything. The next day, no one will remember, and your car will be squeaky clean. But if you'd like to be practical about it. Redacted, shrugs, tucks their hands in their pocket, and walks back down the east path. Should really head back inside. It's only gonna get colder out here. Henrietta Boone stands to pursue Record Purge, who has disappeared into the snowstorm. The cigarette and the impression they made in the bench has vanished as well. Report retention efforts successful. Henrietta Boone has contacted the Foundation and reassumed her prior position. Response: continue monitoring for relapse. Give her the Grade 1's benefit package minus the bonus. Minimize her downtime and observe her closely for red flag behavior. She needs to be distracted. Give her a big project. Henrietta Boone, Observation 01-03-2022. This is recent. Henrietta Boone, 6 dozen other engineers, researchers, and skilled laborers complete the assembly of the Argonaut Transspatial Array, designed for detection of specific deep space anomalous threats. The crowd, including Henrietta Boone, stands at a 90-meter-wide receiving dish constructed in the New Mexico desert. Champagne is being poured. A dark van pulls up beside the dish, unloading a well-dressed figure. Framed by two larger individuals, the assorted staff raise their glasses as the trio approach. 0510. Don't let me interrupt. I just wanted to come down and see the fruits of our labor for the last 20 years in the making. Really, you should all be extremely proud. 0510 takes a glass of champagne offered to them by a nearby director. 0510 holds it aloft. To the Argonaut. The group cheers politely. Conversation breaks back out. And 0510 begins congratulating people individually. Eventually, they reach Henrietta Boone. You did a marvelous job, Dr. Boone. Miss Boone's fine, overseer. My doctorate is in engineering. Oh, my apologies. I had only ever seen your name on reports, but they do put a great stock in titles. You're like me, though. You take pride in your work, not your title. Very good. 0510 raises their hand. Henrietta Boone grasps it and shakes it. After several seconds, Henrietta Boone hasn't let go. 0510, if you'll excuse me, I need to congratulate the others. Fire me. Pardon? Fire me. I don't want to work for the Foundation anymore. I want you to fire me. Oh, we'd be lesser without you, Miss Boone, and you'll have to contact HR. 0510 continues smiling but attempts to pull their hand away strongly. Henrietta Boone holds on. No, I want. Overseer, I want you to fire me. I want you to say you can leave now. Well, enough. Miss Boone, you run the foundation, right? You're the biggest of the big. You can do it. You can. Just fire me. That'll be the end of it, right? Henrietta Boone's hand begins to shake. She fails to meet 0510's eye line instead of focusing on their shoes. Please fire me. For several seconds, Boone looks up again. 0510 has not stopped smiling, but their voice drops when they speak next. 0510 says, "Do you really think I can?" Boone continues staring, holding the air where 0510's hand had previously been, even as 0510 walks off to the next person and greets them cheerfully. Fabulous job, really.
Okay.
20-year surveillance period complete. Henrietta Boone remains productive and unobstructive. Monitor her for another 20. Digital recording of confidential therapy session 09-07-2022. How are you sleeping, Henrietta? Just fine, thanks. Surveillance footage of home bedroom. Henrietta sits with her back to the bedroom door. Shut the hell up, you lucky bastards. And we're done for the night. That was an interesting final one, and I'm gonna have to go back through and look for our spooky ghost activity that we might have caught on video.
Well, on video, but audio. I've got my beers that I've been munching on between things, if you didn't know. Holy shit. I can't believe we caught something, maybe.
I will have to go back and look back through it.
But that is the end of our SCP reading for the night.
I am so glad that you guys joined me tonight. As per usual, I'm going to attempt to get these. If we did catch it, I'll post it on stream. I'll post it on Twitch. Not Twitch, but I'll post it on Twitter. I'm gonna go back through the VOD, see if I can clip it. I am amazed that anything came of it. Impressive, really. Just be like that.
I did not expect it to happen. It doesn't usually happen on stream. Usually my spooky activities that I pick up are elsewhere. I'm glad that you enjoyed the spookies. Spooky stream is my favorite sort of stream. Actually, hold on, let me just... We can unspooky ourselves. We can unspooky ourselves. I think we should unspooky ourselves real quick. Hold on, let me, we'll unspooky ourselves and we'll talk for a second before I go. So hold on just a second. So let me, Good thing nobody wanted to throw things at me tonight. Let's see. You can count all the seconds you want, motherfucker. Alright. Shabba! I'm back to my normal self. Now I can turn our music back on. Turn the lights back on. I know, I'm bright again. I'm back to my I'm back to my bright side. Look at that. Let me take off my ASMR tags there. I'm back to normal. I'm back to normal. I'm no longer spookies. I'm back to my normal self. I'm back to my regular self. That last one was really good. I was really excited for it. I like the vibes. And some interesting vibes go around. A lot of interesting things to it. I'm very excited. We're gonna do this more often. I'm definitely doing this more often. That bank also gave me a chance to voice act. I don't get to voice act often. Or do a little bit of voice acting. I love doing it every now and again. Babies. But as we wind down for the night, I'm glad to have you guys. As per usual, you guys fill me with love and joy and attention and affection, and you guys know I love you. Like I said, Friday is going to wind up being our super special Wizards 101 stream. You love me. You know you love me. You wouldn't be here if you didn't. You know it. Oh no, you're fine. Oh, thank you! I'm gonna chill around for a minute or two before I go. I'm just winding down after all the reading we did. Yeah! Wait, hold on. Yeah, that reminds me. I gotta shout out while... Yeah. There we go! For anybody left who hasn't followed Waffy, or if you're not from Waffy's raid, Waffy is super sweet. I love talking to Waffy. We hang out every now and again. Or not really hang out, but we talk a lot. Waffy's so sweet. I'd die for Waffy. Waffy's a good bud. I love Waffs. Super good friend. But we should probably pass the love on. I'm gonna see if I can't find...
No trouble sleeping? I'm so sorry that you missed the stream proper then, because we did a lot of light bedtime stories. Well, not really light bedtime stories, but we did a lot of bedtime reading. I'm gonna try and start doing this like weekly. So if you get the chance, maybe next week we will do some more. Except for March. Oh, I almost forgot. SCP is so neat. I love SCPs. Oh, thank you for the follow. I appreciate it so much. I forgot to turn the sound alerts back up. I appreciate it. Thank you, Nikki. And we do them every now and again, except for March. The month of March. I put it in Twitter, and I'm gonna bring up the image here, too, so I can show you guys. Well, no, I don't even have to show you guys. March. The month of March will be Oto March. I'm doing nothing but Otome streams for the entire month of March. Only because it is my birth month, and I deserve a little treat. Oh no, an act! Oh, rip! Welcome back. Oh, apparently the dog has been trying to get into my room. Rip, rip, rip. No, I think the entire month of March, we are making it. It's going to be Oto March. It's going to be me playing Otome games all March. March is my birth month. I am a March baby. March 13th. I'm a Friday the 13th baby. But the entirety of March will be nothing but us playing Otome games. And one of the ones that I have on the docket that I think you guys are really going to enjoy is Had a Full Boyfriend. Who doesn't want to see birds? I don't know if you've never heard of Had a Full Boyfriend before. Yeah, it's going to be super fun. If you haven't heard of Had a Full Boyfriend before, it is a dating game where you live in a post-apocalyptic world where you... where you romance birds! They're human-sized birds! Super weird little guys! I think the other one that I had on the docket was Amnesia, Memories, and... what was the other one? There was another one that I'm trying to remember. Diffraction! It's an indie. But I have my buddy Luna, Professor Radu. She's, getting me a bunch of special little indie games for me to play. Because I trust her judgment and she knows me better than anybody else who could be getting me that list. We'll try. I think there's some other games that I was debating picking up for the event, but I don't think I want to spoil them all. I certainly don't want to spoil them all. I have plans. DLC. I am. No. Wrong Amnesia. Wrong Amnesia. You're thinking Amnesia the Dark Descent. I'm talking about Amnesia Memories, which is meme-wise. Meme-wise, Amnesia Memories is one of those Otome games that you can kind of classify as the starter Otome. It's super brief. It's super easy. And I think that it'll be really fun to play. I'm gonna try and play a route that I haven't played before, because I actually only ever played it once. So my name is Star Girls, never mind. I think DDLC can count. We'll count it as a dating sim. Yeah. I think, I've got, like, a list. And then, too, I'm also taking recommendations here and there, because I have some stuff on my wish list, too, that I've been, like, looking at. Mainly stuff like Taisho Exalis and a few others. We might do another, run of... I don't know if this counts as an Otome, but I kind of want to do it. I kind of want to play Boyfriend Dungeon. Would that count? Does Boyfriend Dungeon count as an Otome? Hold on. I mean, mentality. Can I suggest a YouTube channel? You can check it out in your own time. Yeah, what's the name of the channel? It's your Ode to March. Yeah, that's fair. What's the channel? You've been quiet this entire fucking time. I've had tits open this entire fucking time, and you have not hit me once this entire fucking time. What's wrong with you? Are you feeling okay? You came out of nowhere. Have you just been lurking this entire? You're not even saying anything. SCP Explained? Oh, I've seen SCP Explained. Personally, my favorite SCP channel is the Vulgan. I follow his Twitter and everything. He's super cool. I love him. Also, our buddy Genius over there is just fucking tossing shit at me. Shame on you. And I got Poppet back. But Poppet's still broke. Hold on, I gotta do something real quick. Hold on. I'm gonna leave my mic on. My dog is freaking the fuck out, apparently. But she can't see me. Baby girl. Baby. Come here. Baby. Oh, hi, Dinkus. Hi, baby. Hi.
Hold on, I'll be back in a sec.
Oh, hi, darling. Hi, darling. Yeah, boobies. I'm so tired.
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to leave you out. I didn't mean to leave you out. You can lay in here with me if you really want to. You wanna come up and go on?
Thank you, dog.
She's
lazy. Oh god! Goodbye, baby girl.
Come on, baby! Go back to bed.
Poor
baby. Hey, I love you.
Genghis got really jealous that she wasn't in the office with me.
Oh my goodness.
She gets very jealous whenever I am not, when I have the door closed. She doesn't like it. So she got really upset that I left her out. Poor babies. Oh. Let me get my last sippy in for the night.
Alright, let's find somebody to raid! Let's find somebody to raid.
I have no idea.
Loudless, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the Iris. I hope you're having a wonderful evening.
Let's see. We should find somebody to raid.
Oh, well, I'm glad that I helped you get to sleep. Get some rest, Nikki. Have a good night. Should raid Iris. Oh, you guys are too sweet. I love you. Good night. Good night, good night, good night. Let's find somebody, to raid real quick. Oh, hold on. I might have somebody. You're gonna keep me up for a little bit while I try and find somebody to raid, but I think I have an idea of who I might want to raid. Online? Ooh, okay. I know what we're doing. If you do not have, if you have finished Final Fantasy XIV's MSQ, I would recommend sticking around, but if you have not, don't. If you have not finished Shadowbringers, don't. Go home. Or if you're looking to not get spoiled, just go home. God, I wish it was another Otome. I would be, I would be interested in a few select individuals, if you know what I'm saying. We are gonna raid Athena VT. She is playing Shadowbringers right now. It looks like she's in the beginning sections of Shadowbringers. So let's go give her some love, and I'm gonna go watch somebody play the beginning of Shadowbringers because I love Shadowbringers! Oh, and her character's super cute. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Someone perfect to raid. Especially not at the Smash Pass. You can't call me out like that. All right, kids. Let me pop this in, and we'll go raid this lovely bean. And I will see you guys later. We're not good. No. All right, guys, let's go raid. Love you guys, have a good night.